Today, traders, we will be going through the predictions of the week from the 29th of March until the 2nd of April. Lovely traders, welcome back to ChrisFX. I hope you're doing great, both in life and in trading. Now, guys, I have to introduce two new things in this channel. First of all, I want you to tell me if you would like me to be uploading every single weekend the predictions of the next week. Furthermore, I am introducing my Instagram, where I will be posting every single trade before I enter the trade. Of course, this is not meant to be signals, this is just me telling you which trades I am entering. So if you would love those two introductions, please leave me a comment down in the description. Let's begin with the forecast of this week. We will be doing all of these pairs that you can see on the right of my screen. And of course, as you may know, until now, I'm only trading price action and I'm only trading the 1 hour time frame. I'm only gonna get technical just a little bit in every single video. I'm going to be deleting all those lines, and let's take that from the beginning. So here we are, once again, EURUSD. We see price moving below this 50 EMA that I have over here, and as you may know until now, I'm shorting, I'm selling only below the 50 EMA, and I'm buying only above the 50 EMA. So here we are, if we would place a trend line like that, one might claim that this trend line got broken over here, but I wouldn't do that. I would place a bigger trend line, let's say from here to here. We're still in this downtrend, but I don't wanna get too much technical because this is not my trading style. But here we can see price moving underneath the 50 EMA. We see this pattern over here, and I'm only trading what I'm seeing, but we are gonna do some kind of prediction here, the different scenarios. So we have this pattern. One likelihood is that price breaks underneath it. Of course, I'm not gonna be entering like that. I'm gonna be waiting for something like this. So I want this previous area that you see right here. I want this to be broken before I enter a trade. And I would love this to be broken with a very nice bearish candle, which has no wick on the bottom or has just a small wick, let's say. I'm going to be placing my pending order a little bit below the previous area with a stop loss like that, let's say. And I'm gonna be targeting 1-to-1 as my first take profit, of course, as I'm always doing. Of course, this is a pending order, so we are waiting for price to activate us in and then bounce. Probably then I'm gonna be closing a bit of partial profits when we reach 1-to-1, then moving stop loss to break even and letting the rest of the price run to eternity. Another likelihood here, guys, is for price to break like that and then reverse again on the downside. Or of course, let's say that this is the 50 EMA. We can wait, we can expect from price to break above it, do something like that, then again above, then give us a little dip and then a break above it. Then what I'm gonna be doing, of course, I'm gonna be checking out the previous area and I'm going to be placing the pending order. I'm only trading with pending orders, guys, unless I see price retracing back here. So I'm gonna enter a buy with a market execution. Otherwise, I will be entering with a pending order. And of course, the same scenario applies over here. So of course we have those possibilities. We also have the possibility that price is gonna range, of course, and do something like that. Whatever it does, I'm only gonna be entering in these two scenarios. Let's move to AUDUSD. Here we are. Here, guys, if I become a little bit technical once again, we can see that this major trend line got broken on the upside. But at the same time here, I see that price is moving within this channel that I have drawn over here. So a likelihood here, guys, is that of course price is above the 50 EMA. We can break once again below and continue with this downtrend, where I'm going to be placing a pending order right here if this scenario plays. Okay, and targeting whatever you want to target. Let's say that this is the 50 EMA, let's draw the 50 EMA, something like that. And the other likelihood, of course, is that we do something like that, we break above, and of course, always, as I have said in the past, I'm waiting for a nice bullish candle here. So I want to see something like that, or I want to see at least a candlestick breaking above the previous area with impulse and with a very small wick above it. So if I have something like that, even something like that, I'm placing a pending order immediately right here. If I don't have the time to do that, I will be entering with a market execution and I'm gonna be buying if price comes back and retests this area. Once again, it is very possible that price is going to be ranging around this area because we saw this thing over here and now we see this thing over here, but we don't care about that once again. I'm only gonna be entering if I see one of these two scenarios. And you will see me talking about the same thing again and again because this is pretty much the only strategy I'm entering with. I'm going to be showing some precious results in the near future. Let's move on to GBPUSD now, guys. Of course, you need to know that all of these pairs have high correlation because they all share the USD. If you want to check out more about Forex pair correlations, go to myfxbook.com and then click on correlation. And once you are over here, you can click on these three dots that you see and you can place the column symbols and the row symbols. The column symbols are the symbols that we have over here, okay? And the row symbols are the symbols that we have over here. So you can see, for example, AUDCAD with EURCAD. They have a correlation 70.5%. Let's see EURUSD. I'm hitting Control F and I'm typing Euro and USD. And we have this. AUDUSD is here. We have a 47.1% correlation. So this is the way you can check out correlations. But generally, those pairs are correlating a lot. Here, once again, if I draw a major trend line, here this trend line got broken. Again, I'm not becoming very technical over here. I'm just indicating the breakout of this trend line. Of course, we don't have nice impulses to the upside, so it's not like we broke with something like that and then we did that. It's very, very choppy price action and we are moving within this channel. Let me draw it. This kind of sideways movement that we see over here, it's not impulsive at all. So of course, there is a likelihood that this is kind of a fake out of this major trend line, and we see price retracing back down. And if I see that, I'm expecting something like a flag pattern, and then the break of the flag pattern, and then the retrace in order for me to enter the trade. Or if I see a dip, a single dip like that, and then bounce again, I'm gonna be placing a pending order right here. Another very likely scenario is that we move like that, then again above the EMA, and then we have a break. Now, if we have a break, of course, I'm gonna be testing the most recent area on the 1 hour time frame. If this is also broken, so in this occasion, I'm talking about this area right here. If this is also broken, even the slightest breakout above it is enough for me to place a pending order over here, with a stop loss, let's say somewhere around here, and we will be targeting whatever 2-to-1, 3-to-1. Personally, I'm closing partial profits when I reach 1-to-1 because I have backtested the pairs and I know that this will give me the maximum profit in the long run. Okay, these two scenarios I also see over here. Here we have EURJPY, and as you can see, again, we have broken above this trend line over here. I have drawn a channel also, a larger channel. As you can see, guys, once again, I'm only using the 1 hour time frame. And let me zoom in a little bit over here. This looks like the perfect flag pattern over here. We have this. We are expecting something like that probably, and a bounce. And if I see that, again, it's exactly the same logic. I will be entering right here. I'm not gonna be placing my stop loss below structure, as most traders are gonna be telling you. And you might ask why, because you think that price is gonna be finding support again here. The reason for that is that I have backtested all of that stuff and I have clear-cut results and rules for everything. So I know that I'm getting the optimal results. Let's get the EMA here. Let's suppose that this is the EMA that I have drawn. So another scenario is that with the market opening, we see something like that and we drop down. And then we see some price action like that, choppy price action, of course, a breakout once again. If this happens, I'm gonna be willing to place my pending order back here. Once again, if I haven't seen the trade and if the price is somewhere around here and it has started bouncing already, I'm more than happy, of course, to adjust my lots, to play with lower lots, of course, and place my order exactly at the place of the bounce with a stop loss right here, let's say, and we are targeting 2-1 or whatever. These are the two scenarios I see here. GBPJPY, it's exactly the same scenario. We broke this major trend line that we see here. So it is possible that we will be continuing in an uptrend. Let's get a little bit technical over here. It's a very nice indication that price is reversing. Of course, we can get this flag pattern. If we get that, I'm going to be placing my pending order not deep down here, as I used to do in the past. I'm going to be placing my pending order above this area. So somewhere right here, let's say, the stop loss around here, and let's say 2-1. If I get stopped out, it's totally fine in the long run. This strategy gives me 60 point something percent overall with a 1-1 risk to reward. But of course, I'm closing partial profits, as I have said, and I'm moving my stop loss to break even once we hit 1-1, and I'm letting the rest run for ages. So my winning percentage with this strategy is a little bit above 60%. The other likelihood, guys, over here, let's draw the 50 EMA. Let's see. Let's say it's that. The other likelihood is that we continue with this flag pattern, we have a small break, weak, and then we go something like that, and we fall, and like that, and then I see a clear bounce, and then I'm saying, okay, I love this one, I'm gonna be entering with a pending order. This is the only way I'm gonna be entering, pretty much. Of course, this past week I also entered the winning trade using the other rule that I have shown. It's very simple, and I think many people have shown this thing in the past. With a weak rejection from the 50 EMA, if I see something like that, I entered a winning trade the past week like that, and it was a bearish candle thing, so I entered right here with a stop loss. It was below the week this time, because the wick wasn't that large, and you can target whatever you want. But I'm mostly entering using the break and retest strategy. Australian dollar JPY, it's exactly the same thing with GBPJPY and EURJPY. There's no need to overanalyze it. Probably we are in an uptrend right now. We have switched, let's say, to an uptrend, but it is a likelihood because we see those wicks over here checking out price action. Probably we have found some kind of resistance. Probably it has to do with this previous area, if I extend it a little bit more. So we have the scenario that price might be going down and then finding some kind of support again and then bouncing again. I'm not entering here because we have this previous, as I said, resistance zone. So if I want to see something from price action, is a clear break above the area with a very small wick only above, let's say. And then I'm gonna be placing my pending order a little bit above the area with a stop loss, not below structure, as most traders are gonna show you. My stop loss is gonna be going somewhere around here and targeting first 1-1 and etc. etc. And the other likelihood, once again, we have that, and we're waiting for a flag pattern or a small dip like that, a clear break below it, and then for price to come back and then bounce once again. Let's move on to USDJPY. We see that we broke this pattern over here. Okay, we had this uptrend, and then we have this movement that many traders might have thought that now we have entered a downtrend, but this is not the case at all, and this is why I'm checking price action. In this occasion over here, I wouldn't have entered any trade, of course. Here we can see clear price action. As you can see, we broke this previous area with a very, very nice candle, this one. Of course, price didn't retrace back, but with my strategy, I was able to capitalize on this movement also. So here, let's do some kind of forecasting once again. We can see, let's check a little bit to the left, we have nothing recently, and as I said, I'm only trading the 1 hour time frame and price action. So now we see this dip over here. It's very likely that we will see something like that, and then like that, and then a break above this overall area. Let's see. And then I'm gonna be placing a pending order around here with a stop loss over here, and waiting for price to come back, tag me in, and then leave. Of course, another likelihood is that price is gonna be doing that, creating this M formation and then dropping down, and then we will continue probably with a downtrend. Again, I'm not gonna be entering immediately after the break of the 50 EMA. I want to see again a little dip and the continuation. So I want to see this 1-2-3 move below the EMA, or the 1-2-3 move above the EMA in order for me to enter. Then I'm gonna be placing my pending order around here. Okay, waiting for price to retrace, tag me in and go. Or again, if I'm too late and I see price coming back, let's say, let's go back. If I catch up price when it's doing that, let's say, not that, but let's say that we are over here and I catch price over here, then I'm gonna be entering here. Of course, I'm losing some pips because my stop loss is gonna be at the same place. But again, I'm gonna be entering the trade with less lots, and I'm gonna be targeting the initial 1-to-1, and then etc. etc. Last pair for today, USDCAD, guys. We are in this huge channel. We are moving within this channel. So overall, we were in a downtrend. Now we have this formation. Somebody may say that we are in an uptrend right now. Of course, in the small time frames, we are in an uptrend, but I can very likely see price breaking below this area right now. As you can see here, the EMA may be moving like that. You can see price action. Price cannot penetrate previous levels. For example, here we had many weeks and price got back below. The same happened here. We just broke above it marginally and then price fell down. So it is very likely, let's remove all these drawings and draw our EMA. It's very likely that now we are gonna be going down, and we are breaking this major trend line that you see over here, another indication that we might be moving down. If I see a clear break like that, so I have this pattern, let's say over here, and I have a clear break below it, it's more than enough for me to place a pending order once again around here above the area. Stop loss, if it is small like that, the stop loss is gonna go above structure, of course, and target whatever you want to target. Now, sometimes it happens that price comes very close to the pending order and does not activate you for a single pip. This also happened this week, but this week I already hit a 5% win, so I was not worried about that stuff. So here, guys, let's take a look at my Instagram. Of course, I also have some silly bodybuilding pictures down here and boxing videos and stuff like that, but we do not care about that. We care about trading. I only called two trades when I was in the trades. Of course, these, I took it from the previous week, so I was already in it. The stop loss was initially above here, and I have moved it right here because I had closed partial profits, and I said short EURJPY with safe stop loss where the black line is, holding over the weekend, partial profits were closed, and I let the rest of the trade run. And then I had the update of this trade, which was over here, stop loss hit at 129.535, overall nice profit. You see, I moved my stop loss down here and we had this nice profit. I put it above this structure that you see over here, a little bit above. Big banks know that we have our stop losses right here. Sometimes they will hit your stop loss. In this occasion, I would still have profit, of course, because the stop loss isn't take profit, and then the trade would continue. But in this occasion, price turned around and stopped me out, but I had a nice profit. And you can also see this one over here, and you can also see this one over here, where I stated that I'm entering this trade, just shorted Canadian dollar JPY, weak rejection of the 50 EMA at the pin bar right here, and a little bit afterwards, I have the win over here. Hit profits 1-to-1 risk to reward on CAD JPY, and I took many more trades this week, and I had great success, guys. I could have hit a lot more than the 5%. The reason I didn't post the other trades over here was that I want from you to know that now I will be posting my trades before I take them every single time on my Instagram, and I want from you to follow me. And these posts are not aimed to be trading signals, but once again, it is very nice to interact with you. You can type comments, of course, in the photographs, and ask things if you want, why did I enter, and stuff like that. The important thing is that I'm going to be showing all of that in real time. So these are the new updates for this channel, guys. And I'm going to be doing every single week the forecast of the next week. Now please leave me a like and subscribe to my channel for more free educational content. And if you want to support the channel, click on the links down in the description. This is gonna do it for today, guys. Thank you all for watching. Until next time.